The Ripple vs. SEC case is still as hot as ever, but it is getting more and more obvious that Ripple will be on the winning side. What are the most recent revelations about the case? And how could the most recent extension help Ripple? Stay tuned till the end of the video to find out. But first, we are giving away 50 XRP coins at the end of the month to one random subscriber to start on their XRP journey. All you need to do is to like the video, subscribe and comment your thoughts on XRP in the comment section. Welcome back, XRP Army. Even while the term deliberative process privilege appears to be intimidating, it simply refers to an agency's right to maintain the confidentiality of its internal decision-making process, even in the court of law. In reality, the SEC action against Ripple Labs was largely influenced by DPP's involvement. Having said that, a completely distinct court decision has resulted in a shift in the way this defense is treated in the legal system. In fact, in light of the shift, Judge Sarah Nett Byrne issued an order requiring both the SEC and Ripple to produce brief letter briefs to support their respective views, which they did. Ripple's file has now been made public. The defendant's 3-page written brief, which was limited by the judge to 3 pages, addressed the interpretation of the DPP, which purportedly requires messaging papers to be linked to a specific decision or a specific decision-making process in order to be considered. The defendants asserted the following in a statement provided by their attorney, Matthew C. Solomon. As NRDC confirms, the SEC must identify a specific decision-making process and explain in its privilege logs how each withheld document connects to that process, a burden the SEC has plainly failed to meet here. By the way, do you think the court case will end soon? Let us know in the comment section down below. Furthermore, Ripple underscored the gravity of the situation by announcing that the SEC is the plaintiff in the SEC versus Ripple Labs lawsuit. The Natural Resources Defense Council, NRDC, and the United States Environmental Protection Agency, EPA, were involved in a legal dispute, and the United States Court of Appeals for the Second Circuit ruled that the EPA could protect some policymaking records under the Deliberative Process Protection Act, DPP. This protection also applied to internal communications from employees regarding policies. It remains to be seen how the Securities and Exchange Commission will make use of this prerogative in its own brief. Ripple, on the other hand, took issue with the SEC assertion that the papers pertaining to the William Hinman speech were protected by the DPP. The SEC does not accept responsibility for the Hinman speech, according to Ripple, who also noted that when it comes to deliberations about the Hinman speech, the DPP does not apply because the speech was not a communication of agency policy. Instead, any deliberations about the speech do not qualify for the DPP protection that applies when an agency makes a decision about how to present its substantive policies to the public. Ripple added the following. The agency's own ultra-aggressive approach to its charging decisions and theories in this nascent area of the law, where 2 sitting SEC commissioners acknowledge the lack of clarity today, see ECF Nos. 264-266, is precisely what makes the document sought here highly relevant. A video posted on the SEC YouTube channel on the 8th of December re-emphasized the importance of financial gatekeepers and technologists cooperating with the SEC within policy bounds. He also instructed them to urge their clients to follow suit. Crypto lawyer John Deaton, who is representing hundreds of thousands of XRP investors, has referred to this as policy by subpoena, and asserted that the SEC is enforcing regulations through enforcement of existing laws. Comment, XRP Army, if you believe Ripple will win the case. And that's not all. Together, Ripple Labs, the individual defendants Brad Garlinghouse and Chris Larson, the Securities and Exchange Commission, and the SEC have requested a 3-day extension of the expert discovery process. In a letter to Magistrate Sarah Nett Byrne, the parties requested that the court schedule an expert deposition on January 19, 2022, which would be 3 working days after the current close of expert discovery. Expert discovery is currently scheduled to close on January 14, 2022. As part of that discovery, the parties have disclosed a total of 16 expert witnesses. Depositions for 15 of those 16 experts have been either completed or scheduled to occur by January 14. However, due to conflicts in the schedules of various experts and of the counsel responsible for those depositions, the parties request leave to take to one final expert deposition by agreement on January 19, 2022. If granted, the requested relief would not impact any other deadline in this case. The so-called cryptocurrency lawsuit of the century has been rather quiet for some time now, leading many to speculate as to why. It is the fact that skilled discovery needs nothing in the way of formal correspondence. A great deal has been going on behind the scenes, and it is likely that this will continue for some time to be unknown to the general public. In recent weeks, attorney Jeremy Hogan prepared a video detailing what is now taking place in court, the expert discovery process. Both parties are conducting expert depositions. There are two kinds of witnesses in a case, fact witness and expert witness. An expert witness is someone who brings a special knowledge or expertise and is allowed to do something very special in court, and that is, giving an opinion. If I was in the witness box and the SEC asked me if I thought if the XRP ledger was decentralized or not, there would be an objection and the judge would tell me my opinion is irrelevant and I would not be allowed to answer. Only someone with training in decentralized ledger would be allowed to give an opinion, he explained. I am certain that each side, in this case, have listed numerous experts and they will be explaining all the technical aspects of the case to the judge and we can expect each deposition to last all day and each expert must prepare a report of his or her opinion and I wouldn't be surprised if there are 10 to 15 experts in total on this case. So when adding it all together, that's a lot of work going on right now in the case behind the scenes. Do you agree that this is good news for Ripple? If yes, then make sure to like this video. Furthermore, many members of the cryptocurrency community think that there are significant conflicts of interest when it comes to government workers and cryptocurrency holdings. During the SEC versus Ripple Labs litigation, this became a particularly heated topic of discussion. Particularly concerning was the accusation made by members of the XRP community that top SEC officials had links to the Ethereum environment. Now, according to a lawsuit filed by Empower Oversight Whistleblowers and Research, the SEC must respond with a Freedom of Information Act request in order to provide answers to these very issues. The study made particular mention of William Hinman, a former director of the Division of Corporation Finance of the Securities and Exchange Commission. Hinman previously worked as a partner at Simpson Thacker and Bartlett LLP in New York. Meanwhile, according to the filing, press reports suggest that Hinman reportedly continued to receive millions of dollars from Simpson Thacker while at the SEC. It went on to say, Simpson Thacker is a member of the Enterprise Ethereum Alliance, an industry organization aiming to drive the use of Enterprise Ethereum. In a June 2018 speech in his official capacity as an SEC official, Hinman declared that the Ethereum cryptocurrency, Ether, was not a security. After his declaration, Ether's value rose significantly. The complaint also identified former SEC Chairman Jay Clayton's case as a potential conflict of interest and asserted, among other things, shortly after he left the SEC, Clayton joined One River Asset Management, a cryptocurrency hedge fund that focuses exclusively on Bitcoin and Ether. What do you think about the most recent news regarding the court case? Do you think Ripple will win it soon? Let us know in the comment section. If you want to continue to know about XRP, we have got two videos waiting for you on the end screen to check out. Make sure to subscribe and give us a thumbs up. Thank you so much for watching. See you in the next video. Kindly note that prices of cryptocurrencies frequently change, so by the time you watch this video, it might have changed to a whole new value. The information provided in this video does not constitute investment advice, financial advice, trading advice, or any other sort of advice, and you should not treat any of the content as such. The content in this video is for educational purposes only and hence should not be considered financial advice. Do conduct your due diligence and consult your financial advisor before making any investment decisions.